Hello and welcome to Blinding Dark Devlog 3. First of all, you can probably see in the bottom left part of the screen the new GUI, that is the mana indicator. It is replenishing the mana at a rate of around 2 mana per second. Mana will be an important part of the game because it will be used to cast spells and use different items. Another interesting feature added is the lean feature for the camera. So for example, if you crouch and move to a cover, you can press Q to lean over and look at the enemy. Also, the same goes for the E key to lean right and Q key to lean left. This is a new enemy. It is the spirit statue. And it spits a lot of fireballs that do some pretty good damage. This enemy is immune to any type of damage. It's just a simple statue, and it will be used mostly on very narrow corridors in order to defend entrances to other parts of the level. The Zvalin weapon that I showed you in the last dev blog, it will be very useful because it will shield you from all the fireballs spit by the statue. Also, here another feature added to the game is the mirror that will be used by my scrying weapon, which is this one. Right now the shader is not working all the times, that's why you see it gray. I will show you another video where the mirror is actually working. Now I will use the new scrying focus to heal myself. As you can see in the bottom left part of the screen is the heal indicator. It's not yet implemented in the new GUI. And by just simple clicking on the statue, it will heal. Now I have 100% HP. I'm back to full health. Another problem I was having was with the Egyptian trap. I discovered that once it is spawned and an enemy enters it, it will damage that enemy that enters the trigger, but also all the enemies in this of the same type in the scene. And I worked a lot in order to divert this problem. And right now I'm at the stage where it is working. It is damaging only the enemy that stepped inside the trap, but it's not reacting well all the times. So I'm still working on the final damage. Okay, so here is more about the GUI. As you can see, for the revolver you have new icons and indicators in the bottom left part. For the bullets, when you shoot, they decrease and show correctly. And for the revolver clip, so right now I have one, and if I reload it, it shows zero, which is correct. Hello guys, as promised, here is the working mirror. It reflects the scene and also the main character, even though right now I'm just a hand with a weapon. I will work on the main character's body. Probably I will put a real modeled body here now that I have the mirrors in the game. And also the scrying focus will interact with the mirror in order to reveal details about weapons and enemies and unveil the story of the game. So that's about all for this dev blog update. I'm looking forward to see you in the next one. Thanks for watching, and have a nice week. Goodbye.